Hey friends, Corey here. Today we're going to take an in-depth look at the Zap Mass Hog Rider attack strategy, guys. I got three awesome examples to show you. These attack taken out, maxed out, competition quality, Town Hall 13s. Look at that, man. Zapping that clan castle in the middle. Now, important note, man, he didn't get that much other value, all right? None of the scatter shots for the Eagle Artillery was close enough to the clan castle to zap it all. So he's gonna have to get some really good value out of his Sui's. Look at this brilliant move down here, man. He's Sui in that Royal Champion to take out the defenses around the Town Hall. That way, this Wall Wrecker's gonna make it in there unhindered. Check that out, man. Inside that Wall Wrecker, we got some super barbarians, some super goblins that are gonna be able to take down that Town Hall. No problem. He had like five or six barbarians in there first, so if there would have been a giant bomb or a spring trap, they would have sprung that trap before the super goblins came out. So Town Hall's down. He's still got a Yeti alive down there too to go ahead and wreck on a few more defenses. Once it starts taking damage, those Yeti might be able to take out a few more defenses. Now, check this out, man. He's got this Sui over here. The Ice Golem tanked the single long enough the king could get it taken out while he still had a ton of health. And all that tanking is going to mean that the queen can get in there deep enough to grab a scatter shot. Now, let's look at what else is a threat on this base to Hog Riders, because all three of the enemy heroes are. So we do still have a queen alive and an enemy Royal Champion still alive. Other high-value targets are like the Eagle Artillery and then the Scattershot right here. So in his composition, he's got three Headhunters, all right? Look for him to use those Headhunters behind the Hog Riders and also pop that Grand Warden ability in a time where he's going to keep all those Hog Riders and the Headhunters invincible. Look at the Headhunters rushing straight in there. Queen is already down. We still got some hogs in front of the Headhunters, so they're able to also take out the enemy Royal Champion, and there's still one or two of them alive in there as the hogs continue to work their way through this base. Now, Scattershot is the most dangerous thing left in this base by far. It can kill hogs so fast, just a massive pack within a couple drops. So you got to make sure to use those heal spells when that Scattershot is trained on a large group of your hogs. He did that and he got through that Scattershot no problem. Look at this, man. He's still got a heal spell. He honestly probably didn't even need that last heal spell. He crushed this base so hard. Are you kidding me, man? Yeah, that heal spell, he totally could have swagged. But hey, it's going to heal up those last few Hog Riders up to full health. We'll go to times four just to show the triple, but then I still got two more examples to show you. Now, guys, after the three examples of this attack, if for some reason you're trying this and you're not having a lot of luck with it, then hang out for the last attack in this video, because it's going to be really similar to this attack, but easier to pull off, all right? It's going to make it easier to deal with surviving enemy heroes and a lot of other things in the base, like a ton of skelly traps or something like that. So if you have a hard time with the Mass Hog Riders, hang in there for the last attack in this video, because it's much easier to pull off. All right, wounded ones coming in. Once again, we got some zap value down. Looks like he did grab a scatter shot with the clan castle this time, and we know, guys, that's some big time value. He split up a couple of those lightnings and got another defense over there on the other side, another couple of them actually, so that whole core of the base is gone. Royal Champion's gonna come in, and Sui almost got the kill on that enemy Royal Champion. Super Wallbreaker is going to open up access to the Town Hall for the Queen, man. That Town Hall is massive, massive value. If you're not going to Sui for the Town Hall and get it down, then you have to save that Grand Warden ability for the Town Hall. Otherwise, it's going to make your Hog Riders disappear. Queen pops her ability, gets the Town Hall down, and gets the enemy Queen and Royal Champion down as well. That was the most insane queen value on a Sui I've ever seen. Town Hall, enemy queen, enemy Royal Champion, all with his queen and some tanking and a super wall breaker, man. That was wild stuff right there. One remaining hero is that Barbarian King. So he plays the Siege Barracks P.E.K.K.A. to distract the king while two more headhunters get the kill. If you're going to be using this attack, man, you got to keep an eye on those enemy heroes. You got to have a plan to get them killed. Once you manage to do that, take out some other good value like Eagle Artillery, Scattershots, Town Hall, either with your Zaps or with your Sui. In the case of the Town Hall, it has to be the Sui because Zaps do not do any damage to the Town Hall. Man, the Hog Riders are really good about just zooming straight to the defenses in the base and working their way through. Because they only target defenses, their pathing is very predictable, man. You just look at those defenses and you know they're going to be moving to that next closest defense next. Makes it really easy to plan the placement of your heal spells and keep a lot of those Hog Riders in each one of those heal spells. Generally on this attack, you only got room for two heals, man. If you're bringing those lightnings and quakes, you got room for like two heals and a freeze spell, maybe a poison if you're really worried about skeleton traps, but normally a freeze spell is going to be chosen as kind of the the utility extra spell to bring along with this army. All right, fam, next example. Dark Horse is going to be coming in with 35 Hog Riders. He's going to use 7 Lightnings, 1 Quake to zap a Scattershot and the Clan Castle, so he's not going to have to deal with those troops at all. Now, look at this Town Hall right on the edge, man. With the Royal Champion, come on, both of those are threats to the Hogs, especially that Town Hall. So with that Town Hall so exposed, you got a Sui for that Town Hall, without a doubt, all right? He's going to be sending his King in. Go ahead and distract and kill this enemy Royal Champion. That way his Queen's got a real straight shot there at the Town Hall. Now, he probably doesn't even need really that much tanking for his Queen, or none at all, really. Honestly, there's really just not that much there. So look at that, dude. She's going to take out that cannon real fast. Step up, take out that Town Hall while she's really only got one defense on her in that Archer Tower. That's not going to be an issue whatsoever. Now, what do we have left in the base? All right, we got a Scattershot right here. That's a threat. Eagle, that could be a threat. And enemy Archer Queen can be a threat as well. You want to get her dealt with. You got to have something to deal with her. So you could use your Royal Champion and Grand Warden ability, but you might as well back that Royal Champion up with a Headhunter as well. Make sure you get that Queen killed nice and early, and you're not having to use your Royal Champion ability to keep her alive through it, man. You want to have that Royal Champion ability intact for use on the backside of the base. Sure enough, man, we got Piggies and a Headhunter. They got that Queen kill, no problem. Queen actually survived long enough to assist with that Queen kill, so Royal Champion still has not been touched yet, all right? We had a Siege Barracks used up top. Those wizards are going to trim that out of trash buildings, and they're going to be depositing some more maxed Hog Riders as well. Looks like he had a few loons to take out a few defenses on the side. I don't know if it was just the cannon. It looks like they got 3 defenses out there that were not really covered by air targeting stuff. So nice use 3 loons to pick off 3 defenses right there. Look at this, man. We got a Tesla farm that they're coming into. Let's see, man. What's that Grand Warden doing, dude? It looks like he popped that Grand Warden ability or something, but didn't have any hogs in it, dude. Unless I just couldn't see it. I saw the Grand Warden ability. The Grand Warden was invincible, but it didn't look like the hogs were, man. That was super crazy. Bro, the whole base is gone. Dude, look at this. We got tons of pigs left. Royal Champion is still over half health. Just now below half. She's still got her ability intact. He's going to be completely swagging that. Guys, mass hogs, dude. Annihilated another base. All right, man. And here it is. This is really similar to the Zap Mass Hog attack, but when you bring in the Miners and the Hogs, the Miners can deal with a lot of things that the Hogs really can't deal with, all right? If you bring in Miners and Hogs, the Miners can deal with Skelly Traps, so they're not chasing your Hog over the entire base. They can also kill enemy heroes, so it's going to make it a lot easier to pull off. You don't have to worry about taking nearly as many objectives as you do with Zap Mass Hog Riders, man. On this one, as long as you get some good value, generally the Miners and Hogs combination can take care of the rest. Good value being, you know, CC troops. We got Scattershots, Eagle Artillery. Looks like on this one, he already zapped the Clan Castle, which contains those CC troops, and a Scattershot. So big time value with the zaps. Now he's suing his Queen in here. Go ahead and grab an Inferno compartment. That's really handy because a lot of times those Inferno compartments not only have the Inferno Tower, but a lot of times they have skeleton traps around them too, which can really slow down, especially your Hog Riders, and your can really hold up your Miners for a while too. That being said, Miners will actually kill them, whereas Hog Riders will just get followed by them until every single defense in the entire base is down, man. Look at that. He did not get the Town Hall with the Sui, so he knew he had to save that Grand Warden ability for it. If he had had just Miners, they could have survived it by going back underground, but since he had a bunch of Hog Riders in there as well, he had to pop that Grand Warden ability there to keep those Hogs alive and healthy even throughout. Now look at this last backside heal spell right here, trying to target a group that's getting ready to take out that Scattershot. Like we said before, man, with the mass Hog Riders, prioritize those heal spells in an area where Scattershot is going to be hitting them, because it does a massive amount of splash damage. It can make a group of Miners or Hogs disappear really, really quickly, man, if you're not on top of either freezing it or placing those heal spells. But if you're not going to take out most of those heroes, you got a bunch of heroes to work with. A lot of times on mass Hog Riders, you can send in a few headhunters and get them managed. But if you got Miners and Hogs, the Miners are more than capable of dealing with those enemy heroes. Look at this Royal Champion. Is she going to survive the raid? Dude, I think she's going to. Is she inside of that? Oh, man, she's just got a sliver of life left, man. Beautiful thing about this attack, man, is a lot of times by the end of it, all your Hog Riders are dead, man. They've triggered all the traps. They've triggered all the skellies. They've eaten all the frontline damage because they hop out in front of those Miners. So a lot of times by the end of this attack, your Hog Riders are all dead. But at this point, you got some Miners that have maybe been hanging back from the traps, from the from the skeletons and all that sort of stuff, you know, trying to clean up those other structures. And because of that, they haven't eaten the giant bombs. They haven't eaten the bomb towers. They haven't eaten all the splash damage. A lot of times you're going to have miners surviving, even when your hogs are dead, to finish off the triple when you're using this zap hybrid attack strategy. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click that button right over my shoulder. If you're already a subscriber, then check out that video on the other side of the screen, and we'll keep hanging out.